how the blood flows to the heart. You see the image here, there is SVC on top of the heart, the picture there, and there is IVC at the bottom. The SVC means superior and superior vena cava, and the IVC is the inferior vena cava. Superior vena cava is the one receives the blood from our head, the upper body, okay, head, neck, and all the stuff. And the inferior vena cava is the one that's going to receive the blood from our legs, okay, lower body. Now, you see those stars there in the picture? Those are valves. So why do we have valves? The valve is very important. The job of the valve is to because when the heart contracts, the valve closes, okay? What that does is it closes so the blood that's get in cannot go back to the heart, all right? So generally, the heart has four valves, as you can see in that image earlier. The tricuspid valve, the pulmonary valve, which is that is in the right side, the mitral valve, and the aortic valve that is in the left side. These valves plays an important role in ensuring that blood flows in the right direction through the heart. When the heart contracts, the tricuspid and mitral valves, also known as atrioventricular valves, open, allowing blood flow from the atria into the ventricles. As the ventricles fill with blood, the valves close to prevent backflow of blood into the atria. This closure of the valves produces the lub, which is the sound of the heartbeat. When the ventricles contract, the pulmonary and aortic valve, also known as semilunar valves, open, allowing blood to be pumped out of the heart and into the lungs. In the case of the pulmonary valve or the rest of the body, in the case of the aortic valve, once the ventricle have emptied, the pulmonary and aortic valves close to prevent the backflow of blood into the heart. This closure of the valves produces the dub, and that is the sound of the heart. Overall, the valves of the heart ensure that blood flows in a coordinated and efficient manner through the heart and to the rest of the body. How the blood flow to the heart? Well, the deoxygenated blood enters the heart through large veins called the superior and inferior vena cava. The superior vena cava receives the blood from our upper body, and the inferior vena cava receives the blood from our lower body. These veins carry blood from the back, from the body back to the heart. The deoxygenated blood enters the right atrium of the heart. The right atrium is one of the four chambers of the heart. From the right atrium, the blood flows through the tricuspid valve into the right ventricle. The tricuspid valve is one-way valve that prevents the backflow of blood into the right atrium. The right ventricle contracts and pumps the deoxygenated blood through the pulmonary blood up to the pulmonary valve and into the pulmonary artery. The pulmonary artery carries that deoxygenated blood to the lungs, where then it releases carbon dioxide and picks up oxygen. The oxygenated blood then returns to the heart through the pulmonary veins, which carry blood from the lungs to the left atrium of the heart. From the left atrium, the blood flows through another valve, which is called mitral valve, into the left ventricle. The left ventricle contracts and pumps the oxygen blood through the aortic valve, and into the aorta. The aorta is the main artery that carries oxygenated blood, the blood that has oxygen, and distribute it to the rest of our body, providing oxygen and nutrients to the body organs and tissues. The cycle of blood flow continues as the deoxygenated blood returns to the heart via the superior and inferior vena cava, starting the process again. So this continues over and over. Okay? Overall, this continuous cycle of blood flow ensures that the body receives the oxygen and nutrients it needs to function our body properly. Now, if any of the heart valves are dysfunctional, it can lead to a condition called valve disease. Now, valve disease occurs when the valve of the heart do not function properly, leading to problem with blood flow in the heart and to the rest of the body. The most common types of this valve disease include valve stenosis. This occurs when a valve becomes narrow, making it difficult for the blood flow through. This can cause the heart to work harder to pump blood, leading to chest pain, shortness of breath, and fatigue. Valve regurgitation. This occurs when a valve does not close properly, allowing blood to flow back into the chamber it's just left. So this can cause heart to work harder to pump blood, leading to symptoms such as fatigue, shortness of breath, and swelling in the legs and feet. Valve prolapse. This occurs when a valve bulges into the atrium or ventricle, preventing it from closing properly. This can cause symptoms similar to those of valve regurgitation. If these conditions are left untreated, valve disease can lead to serious complications, including heart failure, heart rhythm problems, and blood clots. Treatment for valve disease may include medications to manage symptoms, lifestyle changes like healthy diets and surgical procedures to repair or replace the affected valve. It's important to seek medical attention if you experience symptoms of valve disease, as early diagnosis and treatment can help prevent complications and improve outcomes. And if there are plaques in the arteries, it can lead to a condition called atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis occurs when plaques build up in the walls of the arteries, causing them to become narrowed and hardened. This can lead to several health problems, including reduced blood flow. As the arteries become narrowed, blood flow to the organs and tissues of the body can be reduced. This can cause a range of symptoms depending on which arteries are affected, including chest pain, leg pain, and shortness of breath. Increased risk of heart attack or stroke. If a plaque ruptures, it can form a blood clot that blocks the artery. This can cause a heart attack or stroke depending on which artery is affected. High blood pressure. If the arteries become narrowed and hardened, it can increase the resistance to blood flow, leading to high blood pressure. Kidney disease. Reduced blood flow to the kidney can cause kidney disease, which can lead to a range of complications, including high blood pressure, anemia, and bone disease. Peripheral artery disease. Atherosclerosis can also cause peripheral artery disease, which is a condition that affects the artery in the legs and feet. This can cause leg pain, numbness, and difficulty walking. To reduce the risk of developing atherosclerosis, it's important to maintain a healthy lifestyle, including regular exercises, a healthy diet, not smoking, and managing any medical conditions such as high blood pressure or high cholesterol. So that's it, you guys, about how the blood flow to our heart, the function of the valves in the heart, and the condition that can happen, okay? diseases that can happen if our arteries are congested, okay, if there's plaques and stuff like that. So based on this, it is really important to live a healthy lifestyle so we can live longer. All right, so thank you for watching, guys, and you all have a great one. And if you like this video, please click like, share, and subscribe for more videos. Thank you so much. You have a great one.